अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ लीडरशिप स्ट्रेटजीज। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस द रोल्स ऑफ लीडरशिप, दैट व्हाट लीडर्स डू। दिस इज अनदर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट लीडरशिप, दैट व्हाट इज लीडरशिप ऑल अबाउट। सो इफ वी नो that what leaders do, we can understand what is leadership and what is expected from leaders. So the roles that leaders play, the first role is leaders jo hote hain, they are the face of the organization, they act as a figurehead and they represent their organization to the outside world. That is, they attend ceremonies or the meetings, either they could be the formal meetings or informal gatherings where they represent their organization. And leaders also entertain their clients, means they answer their questions, their inquiries, they make them understand what their organization is all about, what is their vision and what is their strategy to achieve that vision. And moreover, if there is any delegation who it intends to visit their organization, leaders would escort those visitors. They would make them understand, they will introduce them their organization. So overall, leaders jo hain wo organization ka ek face hote hain. They represent their organizations to everyone else. Another role that leaders play, that is of spokesperson. So in this role, leaders have to answer the letters, they have to answer the inquiries, they write formal reports either to individuals or groups, both within their organization and as well as outside their organization. These letters and reports may be addressed to the upper level management. To might be the purpose of these reports is to show the results or the outcomes about the actions which leaders have taken so far. These letters might be, they might have written these letters to answer the clients or customers' queries, or might be these letters are addressed to the labor unions or the other government agencies which have asked about some information. They also write to their colleagues for support or advice, or might be these memos or letters have been written to the general public to make them aware that what services or products this company is going to deliver in future. So this is what leaders do in the role of spokesperson. Another role that leaders play is that of negotiator. In this capacity, leaders have to bargain with their superiors. And what they have to bargain? They might ask their superiors for the further resources to accomplish the task. For example, leaders might need more human resource to accomplish the task. So they ask for the superiors. They ask permission of their superiors to hire more human resource. Or they might need more financing or any other resources to get the task done. So in this role, and they negotiate with their superiors. They tell them about their problems and how they intend to address these problems. Moreover, in this role, they can also negotiate or deal with other departments within their organization. Again, the purpose may be to ask for the help or the support. For example, say if a leader is using some kind of technology in his team and might be there is some problem with the equipment, he may ask to the other department, to the IT department, to come and look for the problem in those equipments. So this is, they have to deal with the other departments. And lastly, leaders might have to deal with vendors or suppliers. They might ask for the about the schedules, about the delivery dates, about the products, or maybe they might discuss with them about the faulty products and how they will handle those faulty products. So this is how leaders will what things leaders will do in this role. They can negotiate with their superiors, with their colleagues, or with the vendors or the suppliers. Another role that leaders have to play is that of coach and motivator. Being a coach and motivator, leaders inspire their team. They encourage them to complete the task on time and in budget. Leaders appreciate the efforts of their team. They appreciate their achievements. This is another way to encourage the team members. Appreciation is very much necessary to acknowledge somebody's achievements. It will boost their morale as well as the morale of the rest of the team members. And in this role, leaders also provide feedback. They provide feedback against the you can say if some team member is not doing his work well, they might provide him feedback. Or might be if that team member is having some problem to complete some task, leaders can provide him feedback that how this task could be get done. So overall, what they do, they guide their teams, they help their team members to achieve their objective. And to achieve this objective, they use multiple strategies. They use reward, or they use punitive actions, that if someone has done a very good job, they might reward him, or if some member is not doing his job well, leaders might take some punitive action. And finally, in this role, leaders have to build the character of their team members. They have to teach them honesty, integrity, dedication to their job. Leaders also play the role of team builder. Leaders must recognize that he must recognize the abilities of his team members, and he or she should assign team members the appropriate tasks as per their abilities. So understanding people is very much important for the leader, that leader should be able to understand the capabilities of his team members and he should assign them appropriate tasks as per their abilities. And he should also regularly boost their morale and spirit. He should inspire them so they could get the task completed. For this purpose, leaders might hold regular meetings with his team members and briefings that how they can do the task. Through these briefings and meetings, leader can also know that what problems his team members are facing and how they can address these problems and challenges which they are facing. Apart from building the team, leader should also play the role of team player. He is also the member of that team which he is leading. And in this capacity, being a team member, he should display appropriate conduct. This means he should respect others. There is a well-known saying that give respect and get respect. So leader must respect all his team members. He should respect their opinion. He should listen to them. He should listen to their opinions, their suggestions. It is not a bossy style. Leader shouldn't exhibit bossy style behavior that only he can speak and rest of the people, rest of the team members, they have to listen only. No. Leader should also have the capacity to listen as well as speak. And leader should encourage cooperation between team members. And he should exhibit loyalty to the policies and the functions of the organization. Leader should display loyalty to his superiors. Or ye loyalty, how he can exhibit this loyalty? By dedicating himself to the organizational goals. Whatever the rules and regulations of the organization are, leader should follow those rules and regulations. Leader will also act as a technical problem solver. In this capacity, he might serve as a technical expert that if any of his team member has some problem, has some difficulty to get the job done, leader will advise him that how he can address that challenge. And in this role, leader should also perform mundane tasks. That is day-to-day tasks. He should also get his hands dirty. ये नहीं है कि लीडर जो है वो जस्ट एक ऑर्डर देना जानता है, वो खुद कुछ नहीं करना जानता. This is the difference between leader and managers. Managers जो हैं, they pass orders. Leaders जो हैं, वो करके भी दिखाते हैं. There is a saying के lead from the front. This means कि लीडर पहले खुद perform करके दिखाए. आपने करेक्टर बिल्ड करना है अपने टीम मेंबर्स का. आप चाहते हैं कि उनके अंदर ऑनेस्टी आए, आप पहले खुद ऑनेस्ट हो. आप चाहते हैं योर टीम मेंबर्स दे शुड बी रेगुलर, देन फर्स्ट यू नीड टू बी रेगुलर ऑन योर ड्यूटी. यू शुड बी रेगुलर अबाउट योर जॉब. सो दिस इज हाउ यू विल टीच योर टीम मेंबर्स. कि आपने जस्ट ये नहीं है कि लीडर जो है ही विल पास दी ऑर्डर्स. लीडर जो है उसको खुद पहले एक्ट करके दिखाना है. योर एक्शंस शुड स्पीक लाउडर देन योर वर्ड्स. एंड दिस सेइंग इज फॉर द लीडर आई गेस. लीडर्स जो होते हैं वो करके दिखाते हैं, तब आप दूसरे से एक्सपेक्ट करते हो कि वो भी ये इस तरह से करें. लीडर जो है ही इज ऑल्सो एंड entrepreneur. This means leader should have innovative ideas. He should have a strategy accomplish his objectives, to achieve his goals. For this purpose, in this role, leader should be well aware of the technological advancements in his field. He should regularly read professional magazines and journals to get himself updated about the progress and the development that is happening all around in the industry. And for this purpose, apart from this, he should also communicate and discuss with his peers and customers. He should discuss with his peers कि जी मैं ये स्ट्रेटेजी जो है ये यूज़ करने जा रहा हूँ, आप इसके बारे में अपने आपकी क्या ओपिनियन है. उनके साथ अपने प्रॉब्लम्स शेयर कर सकता है. और जो जहाँ तक कस्टमर्स के साथ कम्युनिकेशन की बात है, विद कस्टमर्स ही कैन आस्क देम अबाउट देयर एक्सपेक्टेशंस, कि वो क्या एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं वो आपकी सर्विसेज से या आपकी उस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की जो प्रोडक्ट्स हैं, जो भी आप डिलीवर करते हैं सर्विसेज हैं या प्रोडक्ट्स हैं, उनकी एक्सपेक्टेशंस क्या हैं, क्या उनकी डिमांड्स हैं. So he should be aware of these things. And for this purpose, not only he should read magazines and journals, he should communicate with his peers and customers. He should also attend workshops, trade shows, seminars, etc. to get himself updated. Moreover, leader should also act as a strategic planner. This means leader should set the vision and the direction. Leader would choose what objectives he and his team has to meet and how they are going to meet these objectives, what path they would take to reach the destination, to reach that vision, that is the direction, the path that will lead them to that destination. This is the direction. So leader will set the destination for his team, the goals, objectives for his team, as well as he will set the strategy that how they are going to achieve those goals. And moreover, leader should develop the organizational policies, and he should deal with the external environment. By external environment, we mean that he would deal with customers, he would deal with the trade unions, or other government agencies. The next organizational performance aspect is the relationship. The relationship between the manager and his team members, and the relationship that a leader has with his followers. तो manager का जो focus होता है, जो manager का relationship है अपने followers के साथ, वो कैसा होता है? Manager का remember, manager जो है, they are focused on objects. They are focused, they are concerned about outcomes, about the products, about the results. And their relationship with their team members is, as I said earlier, कि उनका hierarchical relationship होता है, उनका bureaucratic style होता है, boss and subordinate relationship होता है. And managers जो हैं, they use their power and position to get the job done. Means के वो लोगों को hire भी कर सकता है, वो अपने टीम मेंबर्स को फायर भी कर सकता है. इफ़ सम मेंबर इज़ नॉट डूइंग सम यू कैन से गुड जॉब, ही इज़ नॉट डूइंग हिज जॉब वेल, ही कैन फायर हिज दैट टीम मेंबर. तो मैनेजर जो है वो अपनी पोजीशन इस्तेमाल कर रहा है, जो उसके पास पावर है, जो उसकी अथॉरिटी है, ही इज़ एक्सरसाइजिंग हिज अथॉरिटी टू गेट द एक्सपेक्टेड आउटकम, टू गेट द एक्सपेक्टेड रिजल्ट्स. On the other side, leader जो होता है, leader is focused on people, not on objects. Because leadership is about leading people. उसका focus जो है वो लोगों पे है, वो लोगों पे, अपने team members पे उसका focus क्या है? कि he use his influential power, उसका जो personal, उसका आप कह लें charisma जो है, leader uses his charisma, his to inspire others. He motivates his team members. उनके अंदर जो है वो करैक्टर बिल्डिंग करता है थ्रू हिज ओन करैक्टर. तो लीडर जो है वो अपनी पावर इस्तेमाल नहीं कर रहा, उसकी उसके कोई अथॉरिटी इस्तेमाल नहीं करता, वो जस्ट अपना एक पर्सनल इन्फ्लुएंस जो है वो उसके उसको इस्तेमाल करता है, उसको यूज़ करता है. तो लीडरशिप जो है वो क्या कर रही है, ही लीडरशिप जो है, लीडर्स जो है दे अट्रैक्ट एंड एनर्जाइज पीपल एंड दे मोटिवेट हिज फॉलोअर्स. और उसका रोल जो है वो कोच और फैसिलिटेटर का होता है, कि लीडर उनको गाइड करता है, उनको फैसिलिटेट करता है. एंड दिस इज अनदर की डिफरेंस बिटवीन द लीडरशिप एंड द मैनेजमेंट, कि मैनेजमेंट जो है वो टास्क को या ऑब्जेक्टिव को अचीव करने के लिए मैनेजर्स जो हैं दे यूज देयर अथॉरिटी एंड पावर, वेयर एज लीडर जो है वो लोगों को उनके अंदर करेक्टर बिल्डिंग के थ्रू जो है, उनको इंस्पायरेशन के थ्रू जो है वो टास्क को या ऑब्जेक्टिव्स को अचीव करता है. तो लीडर जो है वो अपने टाइटल के ऊपर जो है वो डिपेंड नहीं करता कि उसका जी टाइटल लीडर क्या है या व्हाटसएवर जो भी उसका उस कंपनी की ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की हायरार्की के अंदर उसका टाइटल है या उसकी पोजीशन है, वो उसको यूज़ करते हुए जो है वो लोगों से काम नहीं लेता. ऑन द अदर साइड जो है मैनेजर जो है दे यूज़ बोथ कोअर्सिव एंड नॉन कोअर्सिव बिहेवियर टू गेट द जॉब डन. The next performance criteria for the organization is the personal qualities of the managers and the leaders. Managers jo hote hain, they keep distance with their subordinates. They act as a boss and they are expert in their field. They are expert about the task which they are doing. Aur wo apna time jo hai, wo jaisa ki pehle bhi main bata chuka hoon, they just speak, they give orders. And get others to follow these orders. And they ensure के जो उनके team members हैं they conform to the policies and the regulations and rules, उनको वो follow करते हैं, conformance show करते हैं. On the other side जो है leaders जो होते हैं they are emotionally connected with their followers. How they are connected? Because there is a balanced relationship. Leaders जो होते हैं the vision that they set, जैसा कि हमने पहले कहा कि leaders and followers they share a vision. तो वहाँ पे followers जो हैं they believe कि they are part of the part of that team and they have to achieve that vision. वो emotionally connected होते हैं उस vision के साथ भी, leaders के साथ भी वो emotionally connected होते हैं because they share that vision. Balanced relationship है वहाँ पे because टीम मेंबर्स जो हैं दे आर आल्सो थिंकर्स एज वेल एज डूअर्स. तो जब वो खुद भी थिंक कर रहे हैं कि कैसे उन्होंने अचीव करना है, तो दे फील देम सेल्व एज द पार्ट ऑफ दैट विजन, दे फील देम सेल्व एज द पार्ट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. जबकि जब टीम मेंबर जस्ट एज अ डूअर्स वर्क कर रहे होते हैं मैनेजमेंट के केस में, तो वहाँ पर वो अपने आप को उस विजन का पार्ट फील नहीं करते. दे डोंट फील देम सेल्व कनेक्टेड विद द मैनेजर्स बिकॉज वहाँ पर मोर ओवर लीडर्स जो हैं दे आल्सो लिसन टू देयर टीम मेम्बर्स, दे आर ओपन माइंडेड, दे आर नॉट एक्सपर्ट. इट इज़ नॉट नेसेसरी फॉर अ लीडर टू बिकम अ लीडर डैट यू शुड बी एक्सपर्ट इन दैट फील्ड अबाउट दैट प्रॉब्लम विच यू आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व. दे आर ओपन माइंडेड, दैट्स वाई दे आर इनोवेटिव, बिकॉज वैन यू आर रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू सम फील्ड, वैन यू हैव specialization in some field, you just think about that field, that subject. On the other side, if you are open-minded, you are not restricted with the policies and the regulations of the organization, then you become innovative. And moreover, leaders, they are also, because they are also listening, they are not just talking like managers. So that's why people are more connected with the leaders. Followers are more connected with the leaders. And leaders don't require strict adherence to the policies and regulations of the organization. Leaders are self, they have self-awareness that what are their strengths and how they have to instill his strengths into his team. Leaders jo hain, they have passion for the work, a genuine passion for the work, and they dedicate themselves to achieve that goal. And exactly in the same way, जो followers जो उनके होते हैं वो भी फिर उसी तरह अपने आप को डेडिकेट कर देते हैं उस गोल को अचीव करने के लिए. Another meaning of this thing is कि leaders जो हैं they are open minded because they listen to the others' ideas. They listen to the ideas of the team members कि वो उनका view point क्या है about that objective and how they can achieve that objective. Leaders जो हैं they can bear criticism from the team members. अगर उनसे कोई agree नहीं भी करता, disagree करते हैं team members, leader can tolerate that. On the other side, managers जो हैं they don't tolerate such kind of behavior. Management जो है उनका insight जो है वो organization के ऊपर होता है और उस expected outcome के ऊपर होता है, the results that they have to produce. चाहे वो जिस तरह से भी उस उन results को जो है वो outcome को जो है वो achieve करें, उन objectives को achieve करें. Either they are using fair means or unfair means to achieve that objective, for the managers it doesn't matter. On the other side, leaders, because they have insight into self, they have the integrity, they have the honesty and the qualities like that. So leaders, they don't compromise on these qualities. They will not compromise into his integrity. And finally, organizational the performance can be measured through the outcomes. तो managers जो हैं और leaders जो हैं, how they differ in this aspect. Leaders जो managers जो होते हैं, managers they maintain stability when they have to give the outcomes. By stability we mean के जो actions managers लेते हैं, जो उनका execution plan होता है, that is predictable. It is totally predictable के what would be the outcome when they will execute this plan, what would be the outcome. Because उनके जो managers के जो goals जो उन्होंने objectives achieve करने होते हैं, those are the short term objectives. So managers जो हैं they maintain degree of stability, predictability. इसके अलावा ऑर्डर होता है, चीज़ें जो है एक ऑर्डर के अंदर वो उन्होंने करनी होती हैं, टास्क जो है उसको सब टास्क में ब्रेक किया है, दे विल बी कंप्लीटेड विद इन सम ऑर्डर एंड ऑल दिस विल बी डन थ्रू अ कल्चर ऑफ एफिशिएंसी. दे रिक्वायर एफिशिएंसी फ्रॉम देयर एम्प्लॉयज. टाइमलाइन सेट की होती हैं उन्होंने कि इस टाइमलाइन के अंदर जो है, इस टाइम फ्रेम के अंदर हमने ये ऑब्जेक्टिव अचीव करना है, नेक्स्ट टाइम फ्रेम के अंदर हमने ये ऑब्जेक्टिव अचीव करना है. तो मैनेजर्स जो हैं वो इस तरह वर्क करते हैं, इस तरह जो है वो आउटकम जो है वो देते हैं. एंड दिस इज हाउ दे कैन मीट द एक्सपेक्टेशंस ऑफ देयर सुपीरियर्स एंड द स्टेक होल्डर्स. ऑन द अदर साइड लीडर्स जो हैं दे डोंट मेन स्टेबिलिटी, दे आर डायनेमिक, दे क्रिएट चेंजेस बिकॉज दे हैव अ विजन, दे आर ओपन माइंडेड पीपल, दे कैन दे सी फार इन टू द फ्यूचर. So that's why their actions are not predictable. And how leader will introduce these radical changes? He introduces these changes with the help of his integrity. कि उसकी जो dedication है, उसकी जो loyalty है उस organization के साथ. It ensures that जो प्लान है उसके पास, जो उसके पास विजन है, दैट इज नॉट इन कंफ्लिक्ट विद द ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल गोल्स. फिर बिकॉज लीडर इज ओपन माइंडेड, ही विल लिसन टू द अदर्स. वो ये नहीं है कि जो उसने ऑर्डर दे दिया उसने कहना वही करना है. ही कैन लिसन टू द ऑब्जेक्शंस टू हिज प्लान, ही कैन टॉलरेट दैट. सो उसकी जो इंटेग्रिटी जो है, उसकी जो ऑनेस्टी जो है, और उसकी जो डेडिकेशन है उस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के साथ, उसकी जो लॉयल्टी है, इट विल इंश्योर डैट द विजन डैट ही हैज़ फॉरसीन डैट इज राइट विद द गोल्स ऑफ द डैट इज अलाइंड विद द गोल्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल गोल्स। तो लीडरशिप जो है डैट मीन्स क्वेश्चनिंग एंड चैलेंजिंग द स्टेटस को, एंड इट इज बिलीव्ड कि ये जो स्टेटस को होता है कि मैनेजर्स जो हैं एंड जो उनके फॉलोअर्स हैं, दे आर दे कीप देम सेल्फ एट सम डिस्टेंस, उनके दरम्यान इतना कॉपरेशन नहीं होता, डेट इज एन आउटडेटेड एंड अन आउटडेटेड कॉन्सेप्ट एंड इट इज बिलीव्ड इट इज अनप्रोडक्टिव। हाउ वी कैन अचीव मोर प्रोडक्टिविटी एंड मोर रिस्पॉन्सिबल बिहेवियर, डेट इज थ्रू द कॉपरेशन, मेंटेनिंग अ बैलेंस्ड रिलेशनशिप। हाउएवर वी कैन नॉट से, हैविंग सेड दिस, वी कैन नॉट से डैट लीडर्स आर नेसेसरी फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आर जस्ट द मैनेजर्स आर नेसेसरी फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। बोथ आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, बोथ लीडर्स एंड मैनेजर्स दे हैव टू बी ऑन बोर्ड for any organization to become successful. So that's all about what leaders do and what is the difference between management and leadership. Here are a few references. For further reading you may refer to these books. That's all. Take care. Allah Hafiz.